This is what happens when you run out of your dry shampoo. Oh my god.
Why is it so light?
Hey guys! I'm still mentally on vacation, so forgive me. But I'm back. It's been about a week since I put out a video. Maybe a week and a half, I think. Don't remember. I wanted to come back with a kind of chit-chatty, a quick one, not a super long one. I want this to just be a nice, concise, like, getting my actual words out in sentences. I want this one to be a nice, quick, like, let's run over everything that's been happening, like, all of the major events. The beauty world, of course. It's also raining here in LA, so forgive me for the background noise that you're probably gonna hear. I'm trying to tone it down, but my mic is not that great, so let's just get started. My makeup while I talk about these topics. I want to go over Jaclyn Hill highlighters, Jeffree Star highlighters, the Shane Dawson conspiracy palette conspiracies? Strings, basically. Oh, I'm talking about that. Black Friday, Marlena from Makeup Geeks documentary, now tied back to what happened with James Charles way back when, and the Shane finale. So we're gonna be talking just like normal about it. I'm not trying to like stir up anything. It's not a drama video, but I just kind of want to talk about my thoughts, hear your guys' thoughts. Yeah, let's just do our makeup. So if you want to hear all about those and what I think, then keep watching. I wanted to do one of these because I hadn't done like a sit down for a while. I feel like I've just been doing like informative videos, like how to make money, then gift guides, but I like the really personal ones as well too, like this one. So I'm trying to keep it under 10 minutes though. Can we do it? The first thing that I wanted to talk about was the Jaclyn Hill highlighters. So her highlighters had just come out yesterday. I think they launched. I'm filming this on Wednesday. So did you guys get any of those highlighters? I mean, it is her first launch since the infamous lipstick gate, I guess you call it. So I was actually there for the whole lipstick fiasco because I had ordered a lipstick and we found hair in there, or fiber, whatever you want to call it. I was there for that part, so I definitely had experienced it. They gave me a refund, which was great, you know, but it's not like I want to keep punishing her for something that happened. You know, people make mistakes, companies make mistakes, but what I didn't like was how it was handled at all. The fact that she basically put something out that could potentially have hurt people and may have potentially hurt people if some of the tweets that were claiming that were not false. And all she did was refund people, and then she didn't even recall them, which I'm still kind of in about. So it's not the fact that I want to come after her for making a mistake. That has nothing to do with it. We all make mistakes. The fact that it felt like she didn't take any responsibility as a company, she kind of played it off a little bit, maybe as just, I'm an influencer and I made a mistake, whereas she's a company now. So I would have appreciated big moves, you know, a recall, really is what I would have appreciated more. So that was my thinking still when she announced this launch. I kind of think, kind of just got swept under the rug a little bit. For some of these really big companies, I can't imagine them ever being able to do that and not do a recall. They recall things for lesser things than happened. This had metal shards, fibers, all that kind of stuff. So it rubbed me the wrong way. But, you know, I saw like her videos and all that kind of stuff, and I was interested to see what product she would come out with next, which was the highlighters. Now for me, again, this has nothing to do with Jaclyn Hill. I am not a big highlighter person. Like, I love highlighters, but I just don't get excited for them. I feel like they're kind of, once you find a good one, I mean, how good can the next one be? Until, and just wait for my until after this, but. So I was kind of like, oh, maybe it depends. And I was a little hesitant because of the last launch, but I decided not to get any. Robbie DeChristi did a video because she was still on the PR list. And I don't know, I just kind of felt like all that was said needed to be said. And I didn't need to bring anything to the table because I don't even really want the product because I have so much else that I need to purchase in this very short period of time because Black Friday is coming, all of that thing. You know how that goes. Everyone launches stuff and they have all these sales. So did you guys get any of the highlighters that came out? I heard she sold out very quickly, but I also heard, which I mean, obviously no one really knows except for her and her team, that she probably released a very small quantity. So she would sell out, you know, pretty much no matter what, as long as her core fan base is still there, the diehard fan, she's gonna sell out. I kind of feel like she maybe did do that because she wasn't sure if people would trust her as much as they did for the lipsticks, so she's gonna sell less, but I'm curious to see if you guys wanted to purchase any. Like I said, highlighters don't really excite me, kind of like eyeshadow palettes, lipsticks, that kind of stuff, but you know what did? Is the Jeffree Star highlighters, his new ones, I forget what they're called, but they're $50. They're crazy expensive. But the way they look on his skin is insane. I kept seeing, he said he was wearing it for the Shane documentary. I did keep seeing his highlight and I'm just like, I've never had a highlight that active like that. You know, his was just blinding. Every angle he did, it didn't look streaky. It didn't look like there was a line on his face or anything. It also didn't look subtle. So that one just kind of inspired me a little bit more than the Jaclyn one. Some of the pictures he put up just looked a little bit better. So expensive. I don't think I'm gonna get them in the first round, especially because I want to get his mystery box. The mystery box is coming out on Black Friday and I have to get that. How did you guys feel about his highlighters? Did you feel like they were better or just like, some people were saying that they look kind of like pure glitter, which I will say some of the videos I've seen, they do look a little like that, and I can't tell if it's just how the person filmed it, because on his skin it didn't look like that, but I can definitely see how if it's super glittery, like chunky glitter, that wouldn't be very nice looking in person. I will say, I don't know if he was being nice or strategic, although I don't know how strategic that would be. I think he maybe was just being nice. I don't remember him mentioning these highlighters ever before, and he waited until like literally hours after Jaclyn Hill's highlighter launch to announce that he was coming out with highlighters. So you would have thought that if he was trying to strategically undercut hers, because I do think there's people that would have just purchased his if they had known he was coming out with these like really blinding highlighters over Jaclyn's if he would have announced it first. So that was curious to me too. Although maybe he did announce it and I just didn't catch it, but I thought he first announced it just hours after. We're doing a little bit of a natural look today because I do have to go to the stores. I waited until the day before Thanksgiving to get some of the things that I need, so that's what we're gonna do. I'll also be doing like a really crazy holiday look. And I am gonna have some of those on my Instagram, so keep your eye out there. Moving on to the Shane Dawson palette controversy. So I haven't been following it like a ton because I was just on vacation. I feel like that's when it started to come out more, although maybe I just wasn't paying attention. People were getting fibers in their palettes. It wasn't just, you know, sitting on top or anything. It was embedded where they would pull the fiber out and it would break the whole eyeshadow. So that's kind of crazy. So it's literally there for manufacturing for sure. Definitely scary to see that in your eyeshadow palette. But then Jeffree Star had come out with a full explanation, including videos almost immediately. I think maybe it was a couple days after, but how many were affected, all that stuff, and why it did that. I really appreciated the entire transparency. I saw a lot of people also were very happy with that because they were afraid they weren't gonna be able to even use their whole eyeshadow palette. Like they were gonna have to get a refund and never use it because they thought it was contaminated. So it was really nice that he not only had an explanation, but video proof of why it was doing that. Again, I'm not sure if there's any other controversies, but that was a big one that I saw, and I did like how open he was about that. I feel like I would like if more brands were kind of open about every little thing that went wrong instead of just trying to like brush it under the rug. Not naming names either. I'm not even talking about Jaclyn. I've seen other companies do that kind of thing where little inconsistencies, they won't ever make a big mention of it. I wish that they would. I feel like that would just create more trust between customer and company, but I get that they're like afraid to make people mad and like bring it up to people who didn't even know that was an issue, but I don't know. I definitely would like that a little bit more. All right, Black Friday. Who else is overwhelmed and not ready? Because I feel like this Black Friday, I might just skip on like entirely. It's just come too soon, probably because I was away right before it. So I wasn't even bracing for the sales, and now every one of them is starting literally tomorrow. It's not even Friday tomorrow. Some of them are starting today. I'm like, I'm not ready. I know the Bomb is having 50% off all their stuff, which is really nice. I love their products. I know Kylie is having a really, really good one on Ulta. Some of her stuff is as little as $10, which is great because her stuff is a little pricier, but it's good stuff. I do like her stuff. I am the most interested in Jeffree Star's, like I said. I just want the mystery box. I'm not going for anything else, although I know Shane is coming out with his merch, which was really cool. I did like the matte cup. I thought that was really nice, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to do it. Everything's just so expensive. The Jeffree mystery box is already $100. Like, that's a lot. I was looking at Sephora and Ulta sales too. They're not terrible. And I think Sephora is kind of under wraps. I don't know if they really published an ad or whatever. Because I was looking for it last night. I couldn't find anything except for like glamour articles. I miss when they used to release everything on one day. I know it was like a crap show. Like everyone would run and the site would crash. But it was just easier because now they're having like daily deals. We don't drive, so it's kind of a waste of money to go to the store. So if I wanted to buy the Wednesday deal for $10 and the Thursday deal for $10 and the Friday deal for $10 online, I'd have to pay shipping, I'm pretty sure. So I don't have that flash shipping, so I just don't like it that they don't have it on one whole day. I'd rather that so I can just load up my cart and not have to make a completely separate order. Ulta's I'm much more excited about. They have like a big page of all of their stuff, so I don't know if I'm gonna get anything, but I do like the $10 mascaras. Those always get me. Moving on to the Marlena Netflix documentary. So I have not watched it yet, but she was tweeting about it. Apparently, which I think James is what threw me off. I don't think Marlena ever sold it as anything differently, but James Charles's tweets to her kind of made me think it was something different, if I remember correctly. Like, I sit there and just binge drama like all the time, so sometimes I don't remember exactly what happened, but I'm pretty sure Marlena Estelle said she was going to do this documentary with Netflix behind the scenes scenes of like the beauty industry. And that's when he had tweeted that he was upset because he said that was his idea and he really wanted to do it. He said Netflix should contact him instead, I think. Again, correct me if I'm wrong, don't quite remember the details, but it was something where he got upset. I'm gonna find out the documentary is actually fully, oh, the episode that Marlena is in, is fully about counterfeit goods. It has nothing to do with like cost of goods, you know, stuff that Shane and Jeffrey went into in their documentary. So I'm not sure exactly why James was so upset, because he seemed like he wanted to do the whole exposing the beauty industry. I'm interested in seeing the documentary though. I think those are really fun to watch. Are you guys gonna watch it now that you know it's not about the drama? If anything, I just thought it was gonna be about how they make the products, how they price them, the business side of it. But I think it's still really cool and I'm excited to watch it. Moving on now to our last topic, which I'm very excited to talk about. It's been a little bit. It actually aired while I was in Vegas and I almost said, okay, we need to stop what we're doing and watch this. Like I said, I am not someone that thrives on drama. I stay in my own lane pretty much, but I don't not look at that stuff. You know, I see it come up. I want to know about it just because that's my industry. So I was very excited to see Shane's take on, I guess, was it Dramageddon 2? Was it the first one and the second one? I don't even know. Was there two? And he had really teased that in his trailer and I was excited because I was like, okay, he's gonna put himself out there, risk losing a couple friends to tell the truth, to tell what actually happened on both sides, because you know Jeffrey was heavily involved in all of that and I wanted to know what that was. This is his friend, he'll tell him stuff. And they had been saying they were gonna expose all of the industry stuff, so I figured maybe they're just ready to expose all of it. We're all excited about that because after the palette launched in his series, we're like, okay, this is next. He's gonna finally cover this. And he gets on Instagram Live and basically says like he doesn't know if he wants to include any of that footage, and that was very disappointing to me. Not even for the fact that I wasn't gonna be able to see what happened, like from their perspective, but also because he wasn't even sure if he wanted to do the rest of the series. Like, we had so many episodes, like at least give us one more. So he finally did, and that's what we got in the finale. Something that I will think is perpetually interesting about stuff like Shane Dawson's, where they're so huge. They're pretty much just like Netflix shows. They're so well produced and, you know, everyone watches them. But they're also live, as in the reactions that we as people, not me, I don't really talk about it that much, but people were having online were included in that finale. So it was happening in real time. Like, we were giving feedback as it was going on. Like, that's just the coolest thing. So I liked how it started out with that. It started out with the outrage of basically him getting on the Instagram Live and saying that he wasn't gonna do it anymore. It was nice to see their reaction. That's basically what I wanted to see, was how they were reacting while everything was going on. You know, like, what did Shane think? Because obviously he was watching it. And I'm really glad he included that. You know, I thought I wanted to hear more about the different sides, like why did Jeffrey say what he said, all that kind of stuff. But honestly, I feel like if he would have done that, it would have just dredged up so much more negativity. And I think we're all just tired of that. And you would have had this whole he said, she said, more things would have to be made. And I just feel like he did a good job with it. He's kind of walking like a really fine line there. I also thought it was super heartfelt and made me tear up a little bit just because the songs and everything that he was showing, it's so sweet. I will say the timer to when it released was making my stomach sick. Like, he had put it in a way that we were just like on pins and needles waiting for this thing to launch with them, whereas we already knew what was gonna happen. Just like the music just makes it so intense. And at the end, I absolutely loved when they put that green shade in. I literally almost turned it off, but thankfully, because it's at the end. Thankfully on Twitter, I had read, we're so excited to see the green shade in the palette at the end. So I was like, okay, there's gotta be something more. I know I didn't miss that. I was really excited that they added the green shade back, which they're also selling, Jeffree Star had said on Twitter, as a single shade, which is very important because like I had bought a couple conspiracy palettes for you guys and I also have one. So I didn't want to have to buy a whole brand new palette. So it's nice that they're gonna make it into a single. I really did like the finale. I thought it was very well done, well produced. It made me feel feelings. I don't know what you guys think. Would you change anything? Would you have had him include more of the drama, less of the drama, just like skip over entirely? What do you guys think? A lot of people are saying, whatever happened to the break-in at their house? I have that same question. I know that he doesn't have an entire production team like a Netflix show has, but I really do wish that he would stop putting stuff in the trailer that's not gonna be in there, because I look forward to that stuff. But all in all, loved it. All right, this is the finished look. I'm hoping it wasn't too out of focus or my mic cut out for anything and that it wasn't too like rainy in the background. I wanted to rush a little bit so this video wouldn't be so long, and also I have about an hour and a half when it's gonna stop raining that I have to run to the store. So that's what we're gonna do right now. But I hope you like talking about some of this stuff. I know how you guys felt. We can definitely have differing opinions. I would love to hear what yours are, and I hope you have a really good Thanksgiving. If you don't celebrate Thanksgiving, I just hope you have a good Thursday, and Black Friday is gonna be here. That's terrifying, but
oh my god, look at my lips.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you have not already subscribed, definitely subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be alerted when I put out a new video. And I will see you in my next one. Bye!